In this video, I will be demonstrating how to break down a whole salmon, and this technique can be used for any number of fish that have the same shape as a salmon, being symmetrical and having one fillet on each side. So you want to start by making an incision right underneath that pectoral fin right up by the head and cut all the way back towards the spinal cord. And you're going to flip that around and you're going to do this on the same side. So I'm gently lifting up that flap. I'm cutting in right behind that upper pectoral fin. You're going to bend the head back, detaching it from the body, and use your knife to detach the skin. Now this can be roasted and used, I like to roast in a wood fire oven and just eat it as a snack. Now next, you need to remove the first side and the top side. And this is easier than the bottom side. And the way you're going to do this is by running your knife along the spinal column. And notice how every time I move the fish, I'm as gentle as possible. So you're going to move, pull that knife down the spinal column and see how I'm using my thumb on my non-knife hand, on my left hand, to hold that flap. And I'm drawing that knife straight through, straight down, trying not to saw or sawing as little as possible. Now, as you get towards the end, you're going to have to saw a little bit just to move through that that spinal column and to get that tail piece off. And then you're going to gently roll the salmon fillet onto a sheet tray. And you can see that we have a nice intact salmon fillet without a bunch of hack marks going down it. And that comes from drawing your knife down along that spinal column. And as long as you always are staying along that spinal column when you draw your knife down, you're going to get a nice, good yield on your fillet. Now, the second one is a little bit tougher, mainly because you have this dorsal fin back here. So you want to make a slice right above that dorsal fin, because what happens is as you try and remove the second side while you're sliding along that spinal column, that dorsal fin is going to get in your way. So you want to make a slice just like this and somewhat detach it, but you don't have to remove it completely. Now, you want to take your knife and insert it right above the spinal column, and you're basically going to want to trap the spinal column between the flat blade of your knife and your cutting board. And again, I'm going to use my fingers of my non-knife hand to hold the flesh up and away from my knife blade. That way I'm not chunking it as I go down. So here I'm making my first incision, and I'm drawing it down. I'm going to pull back that belly flap with my fingers so my knife blade doesn't catch on that and chunk the belly flap. And you'll notice that I'm also using my thumb to keep the separated flesh up above the spinal column. Now, I'm trying to show you a little bit of a better angle here, and you really shouldn't be moving your fish around this much like I am doing right here. But once you get to the dorsal fin, you want to cut on the top side of that dorsal fin, not underneath, but on the top side, drawing your knife all the way down the spinal column. And as you draw your knife down the spinal column, you're going to try and move the fish as little as possible. And then roll that side of the salmon or any fish that you're doing off of that spinal column. And if there's any bit of belly flap still attached to the rib cage, then you can remove that as well just by drawing your knife through. You always want to draw your knife through in long, shallow strokes instead of sawing or hacking at it. And those long, shallow strokes are going to allow you to readjust your knife cuts without having a sawed hack piece of fish. Now you can take your just a spoon and scrape down that spinal column and remove all of the flesh. And this is going to give you a better yield. And you can use this in fish cakes. You can use it as a ravioli filling, anything that you would use sort of minced fish meat, in this case salmon. You can use that in those purposes. Now next you want to trim up and portion your salmon. And you're going to do this by first you have to remove the rib cage. And you see how the rib cage is kind of curved here. And you want to start by taking the tip of your knife and detaching the rib cage right at the top and get right in between those bones and those flesh. Now, in general butchery terms, you always want to flex towards the bone, because when you flex towards the bone, you're not going to miss and hit the flesh. So see how I'm cutting just a small little line, detaching the top portion of the rib cage. Then I'm going to go back, do another shallow stroke all the way down the rib cage again, sandwiching the rib cage and the knife blade in between my hand, one smooth motion all the way down, peel that back, readjust my cutting, and again, sandwich that rib cage and that belly flap between the knife blade and my hand. And again, a nice smooth cut, drawing that knife down along that side until I eventually remove the rib cage and a portion of that belly flap. Now, it's not too important to get all of that white subcutaneous fat off of that belly portion. You can remove that later just by basically trimming. Now, this can go in your scrap pile, which you'll later go back and pick off most of that good flesh. And again, use that for ravioli fillings, fish cake, whatever you want. We actually tend to use it for a smoked salmon pate, which I'll put a link to in the show notes. Now, if you're not going to be serving the skin with the fish, it's time to remove it. And I make a little slit just to make an opening towards the tail. And you're going to run the knife along the skin. And you want to always flex your knife blade towards the skin of your fish, because the skin is very tough. And if you're flexing towards the skin, then you're not going to chunk the flesh. And once you get a good hold of the skin with your opposite hand, you want to push that knife blade away from you while pulling on the skin of the fish, trying to saw as little as possible. With larger fish, sometimes you have to saw a little bit more. But as long as you focus on keeping the blade of your knife flexed towards the skin of the fish, you're going to be able to remove that skin with a very nice yield. At this point, it's time to remove the pin bones, which run down the length of the fish about 3/4 of the way down. And you want to do this by starting at the head of the fish and using your fingertips and running your fingertips down the center of that fish along the line of pin bones, and they'll prickle up at you. And you want to use a pair of tweezers as they prickle up. And there's no real easy way to do this except, you know, you just get used to kind of working your way down the fish, using your fingertips to prickle up those pin bones. And once you find one, you grab it with a pair of tweezers. And then you can see here I have a wet towel, and it makes it a lot easier for me as I pull each pin bone out to place that pin bone on the wet towel, and it'll easily remove it from my tweezers. And I just slowly work your way down, fingering those pin bones, and as they pop up, you want to remove them and always go back and check a couple of times to make sure you removed all the pin bones, because especially in a restaurant, no one wants to get a bone in their nice, beautiful fillet of fish. Now, after the pin bones are removed, it's time to do final trimming and portioning, and this will differ depending upon your final application of how the fish will be served. Me personally, I like to trim off the belly, leaving that even loin that goes all the way down the length of the fish. And it's nice, even thickness. And this belly is great if you just quickly sear it and serve it pretty much raw, just with a little seared crust on the outside. And you can do all sorts of great stuff with it. So obviously you don't want to throw that away. But trimming off that belly is going to give you an equal thickness fillet every time you portion it, which is going the only real way to make sure that the fish cooks evenly when you go and pan roast it or whatever technique you're using. So here I'm just going to cut about 6 to 7 ounce portions. And normally I'm shooting for about 7 portions per side of salmon. And this is just the size that we're serving while we're portioning out the salmon. You can portion it to whatever size you like. Now, with most of my fish, I like to briefly brine them in a 5% brine solution for about anywhere from 20 to 60 minutes. And then I'll rinse them under cold water. And this will keep them nice and moist and also season from the inside out during the cooking process. If you have questions or comments for this video, or you would like some more information, you can find them in this episode's show notes at stellaculinary.com/cks40.